Good morning guys, welcome to our channel. So today we are here with one more video, and in this video we'll be sharing you Genpact interview questions, and these were shared by one of our subscriber friend. I hope this video will be helpful for you in your interview preparation, and all the best for your upcoming interviews. So firstly, let us quickly look at the mail that we got from our subscriber friend. So here is the mail. Hi, here is my experience for Genpact. First round selected, second round is hacker rank test. This week they will conduct most of the questions asked on Java 8 features and threats. Please hide my details. Thanks. For it is for 5 years experience. So basically he's the same guy. So same person, same friend who has already shared his interview experience with Legato. So on the, if you see the heading of the mail, subject of the mail, it says Legato, but he has contributed us on one more interview experience, that is with Genpact, and the experience level of the candidate was 5 years. There were two rounds by now, like it is, one is technical, one is hacker rank. So let us quickly get into the questions, and only questions were shared by the subscriber. The answers part we are adding it so that it might be helpful at least for few. So coming to the first question, what are terminal and intermediate operations? So basically stream supports several operations, and these operations are divided into two types, that are intermediate and terminal operations. The distinction between these operations is that intermediate operations are lazy, while terminal operations are not lazy. So when you invoke an intermediate operation on a stream, the operation is not executed immediately. It is executed only when a terminal operation is invoked on that stream. In a way, an intermediate operation is memorized and is recalled as soon as a terminal operation is invoked. You can chain multiple intermediate operations and none of them will do anything until and unless you invoke a terminal operation on that. At that time, all of the intermediate operations that you invoked earlier will be invoked along with the terminal operations. So basically you can chain lot of intermediate operations on a stream, but none of them will be executed until and unless and terminal operation is called. So coming to the next question, what is executor service in Java? So Java executor service is construct that allows you to pass a task to executed to be executed by a thread asynchronously. The executor service creates and maintains a reusable pool of threads for executing submitted tasks, and there are different ways to create executable framework like services. It's that completely depends on how you want to create. Coming to the next question, and before going to that, please don't forget to like and subscribe on channel if you haven't subscribed us, and if you are not like this, please like the video. This will definitely contribute, this will definitely boost the contributor. Coming to the next question, thread, how to create a thread and print 1 to 10 sequentially using 3 threads. So basically couple of questions in the single questions. So it's printing a numbers from 1 to 10 sequentially using 3 threads require, like, we can do it using notify wait methods. And how to create a thread, it is like there are different ways to create threads using runnable, implementing runnable, extending thread class, or we can use even executor frameworks there. So we need to tell all those things. Next question, what are the SOLID principles in Java? So basically SOLID is nothing but an acronym of single responsibility principle, open close principle, list scope substitution principle, interface segregation principle, dependency inversion principle. And we are making a separate video on this question as well, because this is the most important question for any experienced candidate. So I have already created, but I haven't posted, I think. So very soon it will be posted on our channel. Do watch that video as well. Coming to the next question, different scopes of a bean in Spring. So basically there are 5: singleton, prototype, request, session, global session. And we have taken this answer from one of the site that we follow. So basically singleton is nothing but that is the default scope of the bean. Prototype, this scope is a single bean, like whenever any number of objects you are calling, that number of many objects it will return. Request, whenever we give request, session is one bean for the session. Global session I haven't used really. So the scopes of a bean definition to a global HTTP session only valid in the context of web aware Spring application context. Not sure on global session, to be honest, never worked. Yeah, remaining all four things I have worked, so can answer that. Why we need to override hashcode and equals method in Java? So basically we must override hashcode in every class that override equals and vice versa, because failure to do so will result in violation of general contract of object. Like hashcode method, which will prevent your class from functioning properly in conjunction with all the hashcode based collection, including hashmap, hashset and hashtable. So if you want to, like if you want hashmap, hashtable or hashset, these things work based on the hashing. So if you want that to work properly, we need to override both hashcode and equals method. Only overriding one method will not work, and it will create lot many problems. So this was about hash overriding equals and hashcode method. Next question, actuator in Spring Boot. So there is a separate video, I think, that is recently got posted, because this is also one of the frequently most asked interview question, like what is Spring Boot actuator, or how we configure Spring Boot actuator, or what advantages we get using Spring Boot actuator. So actuator is mainly used to expose operational information about the running application, health matrices info, dump, environment details. There are many other endpoints that exposes. So it uses HTTP endpoints or JMX beans to enable us to interact with this. Once this dependency is on the class bus, several endpoints are available, as already said. So there are different things. There is a separate video which will be added to the description as well. You can go through that as well. Next question is, what is atomic integer in Java? So this is a very simple question, I think. Atomic integer class provides an operation on underlying int value that can be read and written automatically, and is and also contains advanced atomic operations, basically using read, like get and set methods. We can make changes on this atomic integer, maybe especially in the multi-threaded environment. This has a huge role. The next question is newly added features in Java 8. So for each method, default and static method in interfaces, function interfaces and lambda expression, Java stream API for bulk data operations on collections, Java time API, collection API improvement, concurrency API improvements, Java IO improvements, and there is change in the memory management as well. So maybe after that they might have asked individual questions on different things, but that was not added. So internal implementation of hashmap and hashset, and what is hash collision. So has to go with both, like in deep discussion might have happened there. So if you're not aware of this, this is also one of the mandatory questions for an experienced guide, like internal implementation of hashmap, hashset and concurrent hashmap as well. So in almost all every interview you might encounter this question. If you're not aware of it, please do practice, learn about it. Next question is sorting array list using Java 8. So we can perform using comparator chainer or comparator. We can sort. Firstly, we need to convert the array list into list, or we can directly perform a stream operation on arrays as well. So there are different, there might be different questions that might have been asked here. So these were the questions that were asked. So here is the mail that we got. So it was on 31st May 2021, and these are the questions that you can go through it. Like once again, like what are intermediate and terminal operations? So basically the main if you are preparing for Genpact interview question, you must concentrate on Java 8 features and threads. So most of the questions are from those two areas only. Like if you see what are intermediate terminal operations, Java 8 executor services, threads, thread questions, threads, solid principles, scope of bean, why we need to override hashcode and equals method, actuator and Spring Boot, newly added features of Java 8, atomic integer, internal implementation of hashset, hash collision, sorting using Java 8 features. So this was about the Genpact interview questions that were shared by our friend. So if you are on our channel for the first time, you can subscribe, like, share, provide the feedback in the comment section. You can share this video to other technical platforms as well, so that it might help someone who is looking out for similar kind of videos. And if you are on a channel for the first time, I'm wondering who are we and what we do. So we are basically a bunch of software engineers who attend interviews with different MNCs and share our real-time interview experiences through these videos. Apart from that, we also share our subscriber friends' interview questions or interview experiences that they share with us, so that it might help at least few who might be looking out to prepare on what topics. So these are the company names that you are seeing we have already shared. You can visit our channel and you can take the advantage of the videos. So what you're waiting for, if you haven't subscribed, please do subscribe, because there are many more videos that are going to be uploaded which are there in the queue, as we are not getting time or we are not posting it frequently. And thank you for watching. Bye.